Ragdakund is the holiest place in all of Brahma's creation. Radhakund and Shyamkund represent the eyes of Govardhan, which is in the shape of a peacock. This is the place where Radha and Krishna perform their most intimate and most sweet pastimes. Let's see a brief description of the appearance of Radhakund and Shyamkund. One of the demons by the name Arishtasura, sent by evil Kamsa to kill Krishna and Balram, assumed the form of a bull and attacked Krishna, but he was easily overpowered and was instead killed by the Lord. This pastime took place in the afternoon when Krishna and his cowherd friends were herding the cattle.
My dear cowherd friends, let's go and meet Radha and other gopis.
Oh Krishna, please, don't touch me and my friends.
Why? What is the matter, Radha?
You have killed a bull which belongs to the cow family. You have therefore committed the sin of killing a cow. Please do not touch my pure body.
The bull was in fact a very dangerous demon, and so by killing it I have incurred no sin.
I don't accept your explanation. What do you say, Lalita and Vishakha?
Yes, we agree with you, Radha.
Okay. But how could I atone for the sin?
You should bath in a holy river.
Okay. I shall bathe in Yamuna tomorrow.
Not enough.
Lalita is right. The only way to atone the sin is to take bath in every holy river in the world.
I got an idea. Why not I could bring all the holy rivers here?
Oh Krishna, stop dreaming.
I can just watch.
To fulfill her desire, Krishna created a large kund by striking the ground with his heel. He then summoned all the holy rivers from all over the planet. When they appeared, Krishna asked their personified forms to enter into the kund in the form of water, Kaveri, Ganga, Godavari, Saraswati, Narmada and Yamuna, which they promptly did. Within moments, the kunda was filled with the most pure and sacred water.
I am your Yamuna, daughter of Surya, the sun god. I will be cleansed simply by your touch. Please enter my water.
It would be my pleasure.
Krishna then jumps in the kund.
This pond shall be called Shyama Kund. Its holy water is so refreshing, and now I have become pure by bathing in my Shyama Kund. But you three have become contaminated by siding with the demon Arishtasura. Come, bathe away your sins in my pond.
No, the water in your pond is spoiled by your sins. We will take our own pond.
Yes, right here where Arishtasura dug his hoof into the earth.
All three sakhis started to dig with the bangles to make the pond.
This is a beautiful crater, Radha. But where is your holy water?
It will come.
All three sakhis started to see the sky and waited for rain.
If you are waiting for the rain, I am sorry to say that there is no cloud in the sky.
Are you sure you won't accept some of my contaminated water?
No, thank you. We will drink pure water from Maa Ganga.
Radha and all the Sakis started to bring water from Mansi Ganga with the earthen pots and trying to fill the pond.
Do you think they could use my help, Balaram?
Surely. No one else could. Will they need you, brother?
They tried hard to fill the pure water in the crater, but all the Sakis were tired and fell on the ground.
Oh, it's no use. It will take a lifetime to fill this water.
Then Krishna slowly splashed the water on the other side, and all the holy rivers came out and appeared in the sky.
Oh Radha, I see you pretty and distressed. Please accept our service and allow us to fill your pond holy water.
Yes, thank you. There is no other way.
All the holy waters jumped in the pond one by one and filled the kund.
Your pond, Radha Kund, is more beautiful than mine. This will always be my favorite pond. I shall come here and bathe every day.
Your pond is also very beautiful, Krishna. I shall bathe and play with my friends every day.
Everyone jumped in the Shyam Kund and Radha Kund and started playing with water. In this way, Lord Krishna declared that Radha Kund is as dear to him as Srimati Radharani herself, and anyone who bathes in it will get her love. Radha Kund is the personified love of Srimati Radharani. These two kunds manifested at midnight on Krishnashtami, the 8th day of the dark moon in the month of Kartika. Therefore, thousands of people bathe here at midnight on this day, which is known as Bahulashtami. We should consider these pastimes to be way above our heads and should aspire to be the servants of those who have realized the glories of Sri Radha Kunda.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon. If you would love to help Madhavas to contribute to our next project, you can donate by clicking this button. So keep on watching more videos to have super blissful life. Stay tuned.